What you want? Thank you for watching this latest episode of Cooking with Chris. Today's recipe I'm going to be trying to put together for you is a crock pot potato and bacon soup. It will take some time, takes about 6 hours to cook and 30 minutes to prepare. Instead of using regular bacon, I am going to use turkey bacon, which will make it a little bit healthier, and it's also low sodium. So with that, let's get cooking. Okay, everybody, so our first step in this recipe is we're going to take our onions and we're going to put those right into the pan. And then what we're going to do is we're going to take our bacon. In this one, I'm using turkey bacon. I'm using the entire package. We're going to put that in too. And then what we're going to do is we're going to cook it until the bacon is cooked thoroughly and the onions are soft. So, and you want to cook this over a medium heat. So what we'll do is we'll get this all done. Okay, so this part of it is done. We've got the bacon and the onions all cooked now. A minimalist make, when you cook this, make sure it's on a medium-high heat, not medium. So what we'll do now, we'll put this into the crock pot, add everything else, and we'll start cooking. Okay, so while the bacon onion mixture was cooking, I chopped up a bunch of the 5 large potatoes. Tried to make them into the smallest pieces I could. Depending on how big of a crock pot, you might want to use 4 or 5, but you want to try to get them as close to uniform as you can. Okay, everybody, so the first step in for putting this together is we're going to take our mixture of bacon and onions. If you use turkey bacon, there's going to be a lot less grease. That's the main reason why I chose it, and it's a little bit healthier. But if you use regular bacon, you're going to have to try to make sure not so much of the grease gets into the mixture. So you lay that down, and then you will add your chicken broth, your 2 cans of condensed chicken broth. Okay, then you're going to do your 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 teaspoon of dried parsley, although you can use dill weed with this, your 1/2 teaspoon of ground pepper, and add that right in. Then also add in your 2 cups of water. And then also, you're going to add in your potatoes. Like I said, you might want to use fewer potatoes, you might want to use more potatoes, depends on the size of your crock pot. And then what you want to do is you want to cover it, cook it on low for 6 hours to 7 hours, stirring it occasionally. Okay, what we're going to do now is we're going to make a thickening agent for the stew, soup, whatever you want to call it. We're going to take our 1/2 cup of flour, 2 cups of 1/2 and 1/2, and we're going to mix them together. Okay, so here we got our stew. It's been cooking for about 6 hours now. And what we got to do now is we gotta add our thickening agent and our evaporated milk. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take that nice little thing of half and half in flour, dump that right in. And just give it a... Okay, now that that's in, next thing we will add will be our evaporated milk. Our one can of evaporated milk. See? And what we're going to do, once all this is together, we're going to let it cook for another 30 minutes. Okay, everybody, so it's been about a half hour since I put in the last ingredients, and it has thickened up very nicely. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a little bit in a bowl, and we'll give it a proper taste testing. Okay, so here we got our bowl of loaded potato and turkey bacon soup. Looks nice and thick. All the potatoes look nice and done. So let's dig in and try a little. That is actually very good. Bacon, the different type, I'm sure if you use regular pork bacon, this would probably taste very different. But I have to say, thumbs up on this one. I hope you've enjoyed this, and I hope you give it a shot and leave a comment about what you did.
Thank you, and I hope you enjoyed this latest episode of Cooking with Chris. If you did, leave a comment down below, and if you want to, you can also leave a video response. I will respond to every video and every comment. So with that, I hope you enjoyed the video. Thumbs up if you did, and keep on cooking. Come on.